Alright, so we've got our base layer and we're ready to start creating our normal map. Now there's a few different ways to go about this. One of the first ways is to create a single layer normal. And basically that will allow us to support a whole bunch of bevel types in here, but we're only working on one layer. We can also work with a multi-layer normal. That has some advantages, but one of its disadvantages is that you will only get the inner bevel with it. So that's fine. We can start with that. And you'll see it going to work over here, creating a large normal thing for us. And let's take our rounded rectangle tool and let's pull out a rectangle. That's not too bad. 25 pixels rounded corner, I can live with that. Let's change our slant to down. And then let's do another one. And you'll see this automatically puts it down because we're working in that multi-normal. So it's all happening under the same group and getting the same bevels applied to it. So then we can come over here and let's do a third one. And let's just take that chunk out. And you see we can build a fairly complex shape. Alright, I'm pretty happy with that. So let's go ahead and create another multi-normal. The advantage of multi-normals, even though you only get the one bevel type, is that on multi-normal, pretty much every Photoshop function you have is available to you. So let's take this again. And let's pull out another one here. We're doing kind of a sci-fi panel. You can't tell I like my rounded rectangle tool for that. All right, so we've got that. That looks pretty good. Now let's do something a little bit different. Let's add a mask to this. Okay, nice big soft brush. And I'm basically painting in black. And you can see, I can create a pretty cool effect. Right, that looks pretty good. But we could get kind of a weird artifacting going on. And I'll show you that by coming over here to 3D. Let's open that up. I usually keep this over on my other screen, so you'll have to bear with me. When you bring up 3D, you'll get this ball. And you can see down here it says press space for UI. So we'll do that, and we can switch this over to a plane. And this is just a 3D previewer like Marmoset Toolbag. Now I'm going to up and hit the force refresh, which connects to 3D. And then you'll see we can view our map. So far is looking pretty good, and our artifacting really isn't too bad here, but we can go in make sure we got our map going here. Go to our filters. Let's throw some Gaussian blur on that. Or more importantly, let's do it on our actual layer. Go ahead and rasterize that. That's not too bad. We can also come in then for the edges and sharpen the edges. Can refresh that. And you can see now that's smoothed out some for us. So that's one of our little tricks, is using masks like that. We could also, let's create an inset. So I'm going to grab, this time we'll grab a selection tool. Let's grab this somewhere around here. Preferably on a new normal. This time I'm going to use the single layer normal. Again. And now let's convert that. We've got that popping out. That's not bad. But since we used a single normal, let's try one of our different bevels. Let's put this in groove and get a nice little inset there. And I like that. So I'm thinking I'm going to do that again, only this time I'm going to use the elliptical tool. Down shift, I guess I had that on, there we go, had that on a fixed side for some other project, and I'm just going to kind of guess up from here. And we can do the same thing again, convert that over. And once again, I like that groove, so let's set that. And that's looking pretty nice. I like that. All right. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and pause our recording. And I'm just going to do a couple more pieces to it just to speed things along. All right. We've put in a couple more pieces here, an inset here, and a couple of outsets here. And we're ready to try some of the other tools that we have available to us. So we're coming up on 8 minutes here, so I'm going to close out this video. And then in the next video, we will pick up some of the tricks we can use with this stuff. I'll see you then.